Let's welcome on stage, ladies and gentlemen, Sukhleen, who will be speaking on the topic, Brands with Purpose, Harpic. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Sukhleen and Aneja.
Hi, while they set this up, I'd first like to thank E4M, Naval, and the entire Exchange for Media team for setting this up. Thank you so much. And I think it's great to have seen the whole day full of ideas and inspiration. I'm actually going to spend the next 20 minutes talking you through the journey of Harpic. Now, clearly, how many people here, if I was to say, let's talk about Harpic, or want to see a Harpic, which is a toilet cleaning brand, who get excited at the thought of leading? I mean, how many people here are marketers or people who are from agency creating communication? Can they raise their hands? Wow. Okay, how many of us remember 5 or 6 years ago, the most classic Harpic ad? What comes to your mind when I say Harpic advertising? What do you remember? Hussain. You know, it's amazing. We pay Akshay 10 times the money, people still say Hussain. Thank you. So you're absolutely right. And I think with that, if I was to actually say, we started this journey about 5 or 6 years ago when we said it's important for a brand, which is a toilet cleaning brand, to actually play a much more meaningful role in people's lives. But before I even start today, I'll be spending the next 20, 25 minutes talking you through building brands with purpose. But that leads us to a question. Purpose is a buzzword that if you go to Cannes, you go to Davos, you go everywhere, everyone seems to be talking about it. But the question is, do we really believe why it even matters? Now, I think I'm just going to leave you with two statistics that really moved me when we started on this journey. And it's interesting when you see the Meaningful Brand Survey. And I think even without quoting statistics, I think if we all look at our own e-commerce buying behavior, most of us are picking brands either on value or something is new or we just don't care. The very fact 77% brands consumers felt that they just wouldn't care about tells you something. It tells you something in terms of the way how mind measures are changing. All of us grew up in the last 2 decades learning marketing, learning positioning, learning segmentation, creating meaningful brands. But the very fact that if consumers start feeling, for 2/3 of the brands that were exposed to consumers, that they just don't care, it says something. The second statistic, which brings me to the question, what is a brand's purpose? And why does it even matter? I think it's important for us to realize that when we look at a market like India, young millennial consumers who are all under 35 years of age and higher income disposition, clearly people who are younger, living in our subcontinent and with the right purchasing power, it is the single biggest variable that is driving purchase decisions. And not just that, even when we look at the BCG study that was done in 2018, it's directly correlated with the kind of shareholder value that a brand can generate when it is playing a more meaningful role in the lives of consumers. That actually took us to the question in the last 5 years to say, how can Harpic, which is India's leading and foremost toilet cleaning brand, a brand with greater than 80 share, a brand that introduced, which was introduced over 3 decades ago, which played a meaningful role in actually educating India on moving from generics that we all grew up using into using a specialist toilet cleaner, how can it actually play a more meaningful role and be remembered and make a difference? That brought us to the mission that Harpic could play. If you actually look at the United Nations 17 goals that were envisaged, goal number 6 around the space of clean water and sanitation is a critical role that as a goal could be a very, very powerful goal even for a market like India. Like the way Google defines its mission as saying internet for every Indian, Harpic actually had a very straightforward singular mission that how do we actually provide access to clean and hygienic sanitation to every Indian? That fundamentally redefines the way you look at the problem that you're going to solve. A brand that was built over formulaic advertising, done consistently year after year for over 2 decades, a classic doorstep challenge where the brand would come, challenge a consumer, show the specialist product efficacy in front of your eyes. is the plank on which this brand's communication was built over 2 decades. From then to now, in the last 5 years, the role superiority had to play had to evolve. That's when, if you remember, in 2014 and 15, when Prime Minister Modi espoused the goal of the Clean India mission, that's when the brand decided to play the role of being an evangelist. And it took the mission home. Right after Toilet Ek Prem Katha, we tied and collaborated with Akshay, who was truly taking on the cause of sanitation, not just as a popular actor, who actually acted in a movie, in a popular cinema movie, talking about the kind of challenges women face, especially with respect to their safety, when they actually go out and defecate in the open. We joined hands with him and redefined what was for us our doorstep challenge to a more expert-led communication, bringing the mission home.
हर घर स्वच्छ मिशन पे आज हम आए हैं मुंबई की मिसेज बत्रा के घर।
ओह माय गॉड अक्षय,
क्या आप इस मिशन में शामिल होंगी?
जरूर, पर कैसे?
बस एक सवाल, आप अपना टॉयलेट कैसे साफ करती हैं?
डिटर्जेंट से, सालों से कर रही हूँ।
मैडम, टॉयलेट के दाग कपड़ों के दागों से अलग होते हैं। टॉयलेट में होते हैं खारे पानी और जंग जैसे कड़े दाग। डिटर्जेंट नहीं, आपको चाहिए इंडिया का नंबर 1 टॉयलेट क्लीनर हार्पिक 10/10। इसका गाढ़ा फॉर्मूला मिटाए 10 तरह के दाग और दे आपको परफेक्टली क्लीन टॉयलेट।
मान गए अक्षय,
ये तो तैयार है। अब अगला घर आपका।
But just being superior, just being better, do you think that alone could have actually helped the next billion consumers to adopt a specialist toilet cleaner? That took us actually back to the question of what is the role of toilet and sanitation in the lives of a consumer. We realized that unless we actually unlocked relevance, why do I even need to clean my toilet? Behavior change is never going to happen. If we remember the entire sanitation mission that was started by Prime Minister Modi from 2014 to as we speak, toiletization in India, the very fact that toiletization as measured by access to a toilet to an individual actually moved from 38.7% to nearly 99%. Just in 5 years alone, 100 million new toilets got constructed. Massive inflection point for a brand that stood for specialist toilet cleaning. However, just infrastructure alone could not have solved the problem. What were created as toilets actually became shops, became storage godowns, and consumers continue to defecate in the open because fundamentally the toilets were unclean. And that's where you realized that unless habits changed, infrastructure alone cannot solve India's largest sanitation challenge. With that came off provocation, and I'm actually going to spend the next 5 to 7 minutes just taking you through 3 or 4 iconic pieces of communication which tackled how sanitation's problem was unlocked by looking at habits, looking at progress, looking at the kind of role sanitation could play in a life of a person, which is with respect to their overall health and well-being. The provocation for us was to say that when you compromise on sanitation, you compromise on a lot more. With that, the phase one started with 2015, which was single-mindedly targeted at all the new toilet acquirers. People who had been given the subsidy, a nominal 12,000 rupees to build a new toilet, they had an access to a toilet, but they had absolutely no habit of cleaning toilets.
Are we framed? Achal, ready. Tiwari ji ne ghumale bhai, wapis aaja. 13,500 रुपए लगा के खूब ढिंडोरा पिटवा के अपने घर में ये भूत बंगला बनवाया है।
नहीं नहीं, कि शौचालय बनवाया है।
बच्चा बच्चा जानता है जी, इस सुनसान खंडर के पास भटकना खतरे से खाली नहीं है।
अरे अरे, ये क्या खबर दिखा रहे हैं आप?
शौचालय बनवाया है भाई? शौचालय होता तो पूरी फैमिली सवेरे सवेरे खेत में कंचे खेलने जाती क्या? सही खबर दिखाओ घुमा ले भाई दोबारा।
नहीं 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 पापा पापा बंद करो बंद करो।
वो गंदा हो गया है ना तो बस।
तो बस रह गया ना नाम का शौचालय। सिर्फ बनवाने से कुछ नहीं होता जी, हफ्ते में एक बार हार्पिक से चकाचक साफ भी करिए और काम का शौचालय बनाइए। साफ है तो काम का है, वरना शौचालय बस नाम का है।
टीवी में कब आएगा?
चकाचक माई टॉयलेट रहेगा तो भैया बनेगा बनेगा स्वच्छ इंडिया।
अभी फ्रेम।
That was the first insight, which was just the fact that you have a new toilet is not good enough. Unless you keep your toilet clean, it's never going to be used. That led us into the second insight. So typically, how many of you here have actually in the last 6 months traveled to a village? Raise your hands. Okay. Let me ask you a very open question. Who is the biggest agent of change when you go to a village? When I say agent of change, like if they probably tried a new product, or they learnt a new habit because this person told them so. Who do you think are these people? Kids, okay. Women. So typically a new bride, a young woman who comes into the house. Anybody else that comes to your mind? So typically for all of us who travel, you're absolutely right. It's either a new bride, a young child who perhaps gets education, learns something new, comes back and teaches the family. Or it's probably a person who's like a school teacher who becomes the agent of change. We realized for Harpic, while the entire doorstep challenge was doing a fantastic job of building superiority in urban India, when we went into rural India, we actually had to partner with a change agent. The change agent that we chose was a young bride, marrying it with the insight of progress.
Building and maintaining toilets isn't a necessity for Indians. That's why 500 million Indians defecate in the open. Still,
somehow in India it's become an accepted norm that you can go out into the open to defecate. In fact, people prefer it in many places.
Sir, घर में लैट्रिन कौन करेगा बदबू में? यहाँ हवा तो मिलती है बोली भाप।
घर में खाना बनाते हैं, पूजा करते हैं, उस घर में सोच कौन जाएगा?
Women are the worst affected by this societal indifference and get exposed to various health and security hazards. This is grim news for the country's largest toilet cleaner brand, Harpic, which could only grow if people demanded new toilets. In a nation that refuses to consider toilets a necessity, Harpic decided to turn them into a luxury, a status symbol. The Great Indian Wedding is the ultimate display of a family's status, and nothing else signals a family's desire for status like the Great Indian Wedding ad, the newspaper matrimonial. Each expensive word here is loaded with status connotations. Families dutifully devour matrimonial ads in search for the perfect match for their social status. So, we decided to make this medium our message. We tied up with the largest Hindi newspaper in the worst affected states and offered free matrimonial ads for women if they added 5 status words. Home must have clean toilet. The response was massive. Our 5 status words were included in 30% of the ads, making matrimonial pages a deafening call for constructing toilets, reaching 13 million people.
This initiative is going to put immense societal pressure on grooms and their families to build and maintain their toilet.
These matrimonial ads have completely changed the conversation around toilets. Weddings have now become a key toilet building time for families.
These words are now being regularly accepted in matrimonial ads, which shows that there has been a shift of perception.
Even a Bollywood movie came out on the topic. 5 status words on a matrimonial ad that made toilets a status symbol.
And this entire activation was followed by
building and maintain
a communication campaign which used the bride to evangelize the need for keeping your toilets clean. And I think this is where I do want to make an important point regarding the role marketers play with respect to actually creating meaningful conversation. I think our role doesn't stop at just making communication. To actually drive behavior change, you have to seep into popular culture, because fundamentally all of us change behavior and adopt habits. Habits are nothing but what you do every day when no one's watching you. But if you really have to bring about change, you have to A, look at popular culture, B, look at the role of social proof. How do we actually leverage the role of social proof, community, either in elevating a good behavior, which is the symbol of progress, or in shaming? I think in the entire ODF campaign as well, one of the learnings India has had is recognizing the positive benefits of progress, of health and well-being, of actually making people feel good when they adopt a good habit, has perhaps worked much better than shaming people. And I think in that regard was the third phase which came in, which was all about making India toilet proud. And I think on this one, there's a very interesting insight that I would perhaps share with you, which came in while we started working on this campaign. Interestingly, every time, if I would say we want to take a comfort break, what are the kind of words do you think we often use every time we need to go to a loo? But it's never the word toilet. How many different words can you think of when you're sitting in a busy meeting or you're out and about when you say, I'll go and relieve myself? What comes to your mind? Nature's call. What else? Around the corner. Bio break. You'd see most people would think, I mean, when you especially go down in the rural India as well, they'll use every possible word but the word toilet. And that's what led us into the insight of saying that if you're not even proud of the space that you use, how are you ever going to use it? Because I think for all of us who've actually traveled and gone to villages, and even for that matter, lower income India, you'd realize we are, this entire phenomena of an attached toilet and bathroom is a phenomena linked to all those of us who are privileged of staying in flats. A lot of us who grew up, you always remember toilet being literally sautela, kept away from the house, the word which simply means not, it's a pariah. And if physically there is a distance between the space, it creates a difference in the hearts and minds as well. And that is exactly what led us into creating this campaign, which was all about taking the shame away from the word toilet.
अरे ये बचपना नहीं है शिखर का
कुमार भाई नंबर वन
भाई ये तो नंबर आठ है नंबर वन में कौन है तेरा है
लगी है
कहाँ लगी
मैं ऊपर नहीं
अरे किसी को लगी तो नहीं
कुमार भाई नेचर्स कॉल
तो बाहर जाओ ना गार्डन में वहां तोता है मैना है नेचर से बातें करो
कुमार भाई टॉयलेट जाना है
तो कान में क्यों बोल रहे हो
गंदा लगता है ना
अरे टॉयलेट गंदा शब्द उनके लिए है जो उसे गंदा रखते हैं हमारे यहाँ टॉयलेट को
टॉयलेट
हाँ शान से टॉयलेट ही कहते हैं ₹5 का हर पे बस काटो डालो ब्रश और फ्लश
₹5 में इतना आसान
अपना टॉयलेट अपनी शान
And I think as we go and as we continue on this journey, I think the single-minded mission that we have, which started with providing access to now building toilet pride. And I think that's the journey we've undertaken in the last 5 years of wanting to create and make India toilet proud. And I think in that regard, this insight will continue to remain extremely powerful as an insight. The toilet is a dirty word for those who keep their toilets dirty. And that takes me into the next phase, what next? I think if we actually look at what are the key challenges, why today people are not even keeping their toilets clean. I think a lot of us who've read the Niti Aayog's report are aware that 2021 cities of ours in India are all reaching near ground zero. The very fact that today India has 16% of the world's population and only 4% of the world's groundwater brings us to a point where just cultural barriers alone cannot enable sanitation. And that's where in 2019, we've embarked on our journey of starting water for sanitation. Because unless people have access to water, sanitation cannot be enabled. And I think in that regard, in the last 5 years, even as a marketer, it's a very rewarding journey when you're able to elevate the conversation from pure advertising to actually making a difference in someone's life. And I think that's the journey which has been the journey that we've started, and credit to a lot of marketers and agency partners who are here amongst us today, who've helped us create this entire piece of communication. And hopefully we're able to make a small difference to the lives of people as we build the brand. And I'm very happy to take any questions at this point that you may have. I mean, of course, I mean, goes without saying, I wouldn't want to publish too much data, but yes, all of this work, what does it take? The kind of penetration jumps that we've experienced on the brand in the last 5 years, a large part of that has actually happened ever since we've moved the conversation from pure vanilla advertising to creating a more meaningful meaningful communication by touching people's lives. Just to give you a context, today, heartbreak in India is used by 1 out of 2 urban households, which itself makes it a remarkably large brand. And almost 1 out of 5 people in rural India use the brand. And I think we are committed to continuing on this journey and making India toilet proud. Thank you very much. Very happy to take any questions, if there are any.
Sure. Can we bring a mic outside, please? Quickly. Ma'am, can you please raise your hand? Volunteer is coming. For the benefit of everybody.
Hi, I'm Shilpi. Lovely to hear you talk. I just wanted to understand that it's nice to see that so many urban users are there for this brand. But how are you now looking forward to targeting sustainability, which is like a lot of millennials are talking about climate change and the fact that especially these sanitary products actually have a lot of chemical in them, which goes into the water, right? So, like I myself, I'm grappling with how to use household products which use less chemicals. Mm-hmm. So, is there a thought process on that that Heartbreak is addressing that?
I think it's a very good question, and thank you for asking us that.
Thank you.
I think all of us as marketers right now, I can tell you with certainty, everyone today, at least in intent, is committed, right? Specifically speaking for Heartbreak, all the Heartbreak products today are absolutely safe to be used in twin pit toilets. So, 100 million new toilets that the government of India constructed, large proportion of those are twin pit toilets. The product that we are talking of is absolutely safe to be used in the twin pit toilet. It absolutely does not interfere with the pH levels in the soil, number one. Number two, the common practice in India, if you've noticed, and I think all of us know in our homes, we are extreme value conscious consumers, right? We tend to use the same laundry detergent that we use to clean our clothes. We use it in a versatile manner throughout the house, whether to clean our floors or to clean our loos. I'm super happy to at least say that the products like Heartbreak actually use only 1/5 the water that you need versus when you actually clean the same surface area with detergents. So if I can give you even basic statistics, 9% of the water that is used, groundwater that is used in home. Within that 9%, 60% goes behind cleaning. And the single biggest culprit when it comes to cleaning is actually toilets. 20% of the water in home is used behind cleaning loos. The moment you've actually switched to a specialist cleaner versus using any foamy lathering product, you automatically reduce your water consumption. And the same goes for the 5 rupee product that we introduced. It's safe for twin pit toilets, it uses 1/5 the water. So definitely it helps people. I mean, if of course in our journey to create better products, ideal is to create flushless products. And I think that's the kind of stream that we would be working on towards as well.
Thank you.